Have you ever wanted superpowers? Well, today I am going to teach you the power of levitation with my flying ping pong ball experiment. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we talk about all things space and science. So grab your hairdryer and your ping pong balls because we're about to levitate. Emily's Science Lab, stay curious. For this one, you need a hairdryer. This is my Dyson Airwrap. It's why it looks funny, but any hairdryer will do. A ping pong ball and a small balloon. The first thing you want to do is take your ping pong ball and your hairdryer, turn your hairdryer on, put your ping pong ball above it. One, two, three. Ah! Whoops. One, two, three. You'll notice that the ping pong ball is floating. That's because the air is pushing on the ping pong ball, overcoming the force of gravity, right? Gravity is pushing our ping pong ball downward and the air is pushing it upward. But watch what happens when I do this. If you tilt your hairdryer, the ball goes this way. It's like I'm levitating it over here. Look at that. It's like I have superpowers. And you'll notice that the ball gets a little wiggly. So what's happening here? Well, you have a lot of fast-moving air coming out of your hairdryer, right? Well, due to something called Bernoulli's principle, when you have fast-moving air, that creates an area of low pressure. So we have this cone of low pressure that our ping pong ball is sitting inside. And anytime it tries to leave that cone, the atmospheric air, which is greater, more powerful, starts to push it back in to that area of low pressure, our cone of low pressure. That's what's allowing us to move our ping pong ball to the sides. Right? It doesn't feel like we should be able to do that, but because of Bernoulli's principle, we can. But eventually, watch this, if you get it too far to the side, the force of gravity becomes too great and it just falls down. Just about here, it's getting so wiggly, it's getting so wiggly, it's getting so wiggly. The air pressure dynamic is battling, it's battling, it's battling, it's battling. And then eventually, gravity wins and it falls down. So here's another thing you can do with this experiment. Our ping pong ball wins a little bit like here, right? That's about how far the gravity was able to push it down. But what if we tried something lighter, like a balloon? Gravity won't be able to push it down as far, so what do you think will happen when I use a balloon instead? Let's try it out. It goes so much higher. Look at that. Whoa. Here's another thing you can try. Most hair dryers will have different settings on them, low, medium, and high. So I'm gonna go ahead and put mine on the lowest setting and let's see how that changes. It doesn't move as high, right? Because it's not having as much force on our balloon, so gravity is able to win a little bit more and push our balloon down further. And we can do this. Look at that, isn't that so cool? See how far you can push it. It's wiggling now. Our low pressure cone and our higher atmospheric pressure are battling it out. Who's gonna win? Whoa, 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 whoa. Look at that. And eventually, gravity pushes it back down. So this is my low setting. This is medium. And this is high. Thanks for making flying ping pong balls with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring books for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Dang it. Why? Emily's Science Lab.